here with you. Do you like women to be here?
You see, a bug fly through here, so.
Are you upset that no one comes to this church anymore? Do you wonder where all of your friends went?
Is someone just... Okay.
Who's here?
Well, that was very, very non-radio.
Who's here? Is the Reverend here? Is the Rector here?
Interesting.
Who's buried in this church?
Yeah, he definitely said a name.
He said me.
He said what?
He said me.
Me?
Me.
I thought he said William.
Might have been William.
It's not what I said in the wrestling, because I heard shout out.
Who's buried in this church?
Do you like alcohol?
It's an affirmative.
Do you like a nice pot of mead or wine? Or a strong pint of ale?
And a bit,
yeah. He's communicating, yeah, definitely.
Should we leave you some ale?
That's it.
Did you say something?
That's it.
He said something. He said definitely something.
He's talking.
Oh, that sounds fun. Maybe we can have some of the other girls come and drink some ale with us.
He's definitely talking to you.
Well, if I promise to leave you some ale, will you do something for me?
What was that? Yes.
Yep.
Will you open this church door for me if I bring you some ale? If I bring you some ale or some mead, will you open this church door for me? I know you've done it before, for my friend here. I know you can do it.
I keep hearing him calling you love. It's just a combination of words, right?
Can you try to open the door for me? I know it's heavy. I know the lash is strong, but I know you can do it.
Ask if he likes children.
Do you like children, Reverend?
Yes.
Do you have any children, Reverend?
He's definitely saying significant things, I think, Eddie.
How many people are buried in this church?
Interesting. 11.
How many?
Got a headache coming in.
It's starting to build up now, definitely.
How many spirits are with us?
Two.
I had six.
Is there a woman here? I'm going to count to the number 10. And when I say 10, I want all of the spirits here to say their names. Please. I'm going to count to the number 10. And when I say 10, I would like all of the spirits here to say their names. Are you ready? Yes, I am. One. Two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Peter. I got pizza. That's in her bag. I just wanted to point out there was a bug that just flew past here.
Yeah, that's probably
on
me.
And
I've given you one. What's your other man's name here?
Walter.
Walter. Ask if Walter is here.
Walter, because I also thought I heard Paul. Right after that. Is Walter here?
Yeah.
Release me. Did you hear that?
Yeah,
that's interesting.
Yeah.
You can release yourself. You don't have to stay here. You don't have to stay here.
There's another voice there. Did you hear that?
If you would like to be released, you don't have to stay here. You can just look around for someone in the spirit world that you know.
Ooh, did someone say something there?
And just walk towards them.
Nobody? Male? It was a son.
Mother,
ooh.
Your father? Your child? Talk to you. We'll keep talking to you. What would you like us to talk about? Are you next to me here?
Oh, that was a old room for us.
Yeah, I can hear what it made out with the sound.
Are you here, Thelma?
Yep. tell me.
I'm feeling a bit sick.
Nauseous?
No, sticky, yeah, I'm feeling nauseous. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to set that for a minute.
Are you
okay?
Yeah, I think I'm hungry.
There's a feeling.
It's egg-rated.
Yep.
Ask about his life and why he became a priest and those sort of things. I'll be back in a second.
Why did you become a rector? Why did you want to be part of the church? Why did you want to be part of the church? Did you have parties in this church? Did you have parties in this church? Did you have gatherings in this church? Did you have festivals in this church? Did you drink wine in this church? Did you have women in this church?
Dave, just pop out and see if Chris is okay.
Why don't you move on with your family? Why do you stay here in this church? Walter? Are you here, Walter? Why are you laughing? Who's laughing at me? Who's laughing at me? Say your name. Is our friend ill? Does our friend need to rest? Very shortly, you can't come with us.
Chris,
are you okay?
Chris, are you okay?
You're right.
Still coming back in.
The what?
Was it S15? Uh-huh. Yeah, still coming back in.
When we leave in a short while, you won't be able to come with us. You won't be able to talk to us. You cannot come with us. And so now we are going to say goodbye to you and go back to the colonies. Do you want to say goodbye? Me coughing. Will you say goodbye to my daughters?
I said your name.
Ilsa.
I heard that as well. It's a bit scary. That's amazing.
Yeah, like did you say goodbye to Eva? Can you say goodbye to me?
Oh, come and say goodbye to all the girls, please.
I came so far to see you. Can you say goodbye to me?
How many thousands of miles? About 3,500 miles.
4,000.
4,000 miles. Now that was a non-radio voice.
Are you okay? I'm talking to the woman. I'm sorry, but I have to go. You don't have to stay here. You can go on. But you cannot come with me, and you cannot come with my family. But you don't have to stay here.
I'm just going to sit where you are just for a couple of minutes, and I'm going to talk to him, and then we'll do a closing session, and then we'll go. Okay, folks, we are going now. Unfortunately, it's getting a bit too late for us. We've got other things to do. But I thank you for at least participating, and at least you got one name correct. Thank you for that. Are you happy that these people have come here tonight? Dave, do you want to say anything?
I want to thank you for having us here. You're a most hospitable guest.
Host,
I should say, sorry. And we thank you for your hospitality. We're not wearing out our welcome, are we?
Apparently.
Are there any spirits who are American here? Any persons who are American spirit? Two.
Slowly.
And who are they?
Let's say Spence. Sound like Spence.
You couldn't see it, can you? Now, the weird thing is, they mentioned Elsa's name.
Elsa, yeah.
So Eva was sat here.
Elsa's very goodbye.
Do you want to say to her with me, to say goodbye and say thank you before mentioning my name? And you can give her the other time. Just say, I'm just saying who you are and say thank you for mentioning me.
I'm Elsa. Thank you for saying goodbye to me.
She said she spoke to you, she thanked you. Could you answer her back, please? I think it's gone quiet now, isn't it?
Yeah.
But I tell you what, there'd be a rich stream of activity in there.
Yes.
And when you listen to it, you're thinking, why didn't I hear that? That's how it works.
Yes.
Alright.
Okay, so I'm just going to do... And then I want to get a group photo. On your leave, I want to drop by the base and just say, look, will you please stop saying that my head's over?
You okay?
I'm watching, is it, I think it's 29, is it, Dave?
29?
Yeah, and it flew, a guy from Greece wrote to the Russian government and asked if he could fly to Stratosphere in the MiG-29. And they did. He went over to there and he flew up and it was just amazing. Once he got up there, you were right in the edge of space and looking down, it was just incredible, you know? And the MiG-29 is the only plane that can actually go into a stationary position, and it flew straight up and he said, what's this, the pilot? And he took the plane up and he just held it there for about 10 seconds. And then he landed.
Oh my God. It
must be incredible.
Talk about a belly drop, huh?
Yeah. Well, they strapped in though, aren't they?
Oh yeah, they're getting G-suits now too. Good time. And it keeps your blood up in your torso where your organs are, so they black out. Okay, guys, we can just do a quick close down, and if anybody wants to say anything, can come over. Well, I need to bring this forward a bit. Okay, we've come to the end of tonight's session, and quite an interesting one, I hasten to add. As we've reported previously, with the PSB 7 running through a speaker, ordinarily you can't hear everything that is being said on the ghost box, and so much of what we discover is found later on editing. So I'm hopeful we've got some really good responses there. I certainly heard a few, and no doubt Ursula in a minute will tell you about what she heard or what she thought that she heard. But the most intriguing aspect was they mentioned one of the people that are here tonight, which is Ilsa. And Ilsa did not take part in the ghost box session. It was Eva who was sat there with Ursula. And so it was interesting that they kind of reached out to her, even though she wasn't actually sat there when they were going through the entire session. With regard to everything else, I haven't seen anything particularly weird or unusual tonight, but then that is the nature of these buildings, because quite often they catch you when you're unaware, when you're not watching. When your attention is diverted somewhere else, that's when it's more likely for activity to occur. But having said that, with everything else, I thoroughly enjoyed it, and particularly the company of our friends here that have come all the way over from Chicago, and certainly a very, very cold and bitter night, to say the very least. So I'm quite pleased with what we got as far as responses, and I'm certainly looking forward to editing the video. And as always, of course, you will know what we've captured way before I've actually edited it. So thank you very much, everybody, for tuning in. But before we go, just a few
fittings and thank yous from some of the guests here tonight. I'll start off with Eddie. Eddie, tell the camera, what have you experienced?
Well, I will have to say the real one that got me was the mentioning of Ilsa's name.
Yeah, that was quite, and it was clear.
It was impressive. That was impressive.
You know, the randomness of anybody on the radio actually saying a German name, mm-hmm. that's what Ilsa, and it's Polish as well, isn't it?
German.
Just German.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The chances of somebody mentioning a German name on a British radio frequency mm-hmm. is incredibly...
Pretty zero.
At just the right time as well.
Yeah, indeed. That was impressive, I've got to say. As you know, a lot of the stuff with spirit boxes I've never really been into, but that was good.
Yeah, I think Eddie's really getting into the prospect of it.
A lady, I heard the voice saying, release me.
Oh, release me as well. No, that came across.
That was extremely... That ties in really good to the church.
And was that when you mentioned water, wasn't it? You were asking about water.
I don't know what it was.
And then you had a voice shout, release me.
It was a female voice.
But it was a female.
Mm-hmm.
It was so emphatic, almost like she had someone keeping her mouth closed.
Hang on a sec.
We'll
come to you in a second, and you can tell us.
Oh, sorry.
You're on camera.
Oh, that's right. I'm not on camera.
No, it's been quite an exciting night tonight. Ursula's got a lot that she wants to say. Well, Eddie, we'll cut it short because it's very, very cold. So, Ursula, if you could step over into the firing line, please.
Sorry, I forgot you were...
Okay, what did you experience on the first
one? It was amazing. The right at the end, I mean, we got a lot of responses. We heard some very specific voices, including this repeating sort of gruff, low male voice.
And then, that's normally a precursor.
Oh, absolutely. But I heard this gruff male voice say, Holton.
Really?
Almost immediately when we started, and you'll hear it on the recordings that we did. It was amazing to hear my daughter's name, Ilsa. Almost done and getting ready to say goodbye. It was really, really cool. It's amazing is the only word for it. It's amazing. So that was really something. And then that female voice saying, release me. It was just like she was, I mean, you really felt like it was someone that was being held.
She faces me pleading.
Yeah, someone that was captive and had, she seized that moment to just plead for help. I'm not a medium and I don't ever do things like try to release spirits or anything like that, but I felt compelled to just say a few words and tell her, you can go, you don't have to stay here.
Anything else apart from that though?
It was amazing. There were so many voices that came through. I didn't mention it when we were recording the spirit box, but I was amazed at the number of American voices I heard coming through. And I was wondering, you asked at the end of the session if there were any American spirits here, and I started to wonder. And then realizing, as we heard some of the fighter planes still going overhead, and I know you said American planes.
We're surrounded by Americans tonight, yeah.
You know, and I know my partner Dave, the fondness that he has for this whole area. I haven't been stationed at Lake and Heath. And of course there would be, you know, and what great fun and what great memories he has of exploring this whole area.
Well, the association with the Americans goes back to World War II.
Absolutely. So of course there are Americans here, and of course the church was operative, it seems, until... you know, just about 20 years ago or so. So I'm sure there were many Americans that were very fond of this church. And of course, as you well know in death, you know, we don't tend to hang around cemeteries and funeral homes, but places that we loved to be in life.
But just basically spiritual footprints.
Exactly, right. So it's fascinating.
So overall, how would you rate Santon?
I love it. I can't wait to come back. And I can't wait to go home, first of all, and listen to all of the audio recordings, because I'm sure it's going to be a gold mine to listen to all the recordings.
The last time I did an investigation in this country, you know, apart from when we went to the Martello, previous to that, it was a lady called Mary Freer that came over from North Carolina. And we went to Bradford Church in Essex, which is
the oldest church in England. It dates back to 650 AD. It's a very, very early church. And she was sat there with a fan called her, and she said, "I'm getting this unusual shape." And what she actually caught, it looked like a pair of bongo drums, but it wasn't. They were light bulbs, and they were bouncing up and down the wall of the church wall. It was just amazing. So quite often, when you bring people in outside of the environment here, it sometimes kicks off an interesting interaction. So I'm looking forward to what I'm going to find on the videotapes when I go through them.
Yes.
But anyway, thank you very much for joining us tonight. And anybody else want to say anything? Ilsa, what about you, about your experience of hearing your name? Did that creep you out?
It was weird. I don't know why it said that.
Okay.
Go on, yeah.
Come on, that'd be cheeky.
No one's in this strange and unexpected.
Nobody watches this show.
Elsa, you were sat at the back there, wasn't you? You wasn't part of the session, and yet what happened?
The box said my name. It's like goodbye to me.
And what's the chances of somebody saying your name?
Very rare.
Very rare.
No one even knows how to say my name.
Obviously, whoever's in spirit, whoever it was, obviously took a shine to you for some reason or other. Eva, what about yourself? Anything? You've done some camera operating tonight, and you've also sat down there. So, what has you felt or experienced?
The biggest thing for me is probably the temperature, the way temperature moves to the evening. It's obviously very cold here, just because of the season. But you could definitely feel some sort of fluctuation, especially when we were sat in the pew over here, feeling how very cold it got. I can remember specifically a moment where my back just covered with goosebumps or some kind of electricity, and then feeling the frigidness of the cold was very interesting many times throughout the night. So
you thoroughly enjoyed yourself
very
being here.
So.
And your first haunted church in Britain.
Mm-hmm.
You've never been to the country, and yet you've done
never,
all this so far, haven't you? How many days have you been here?
Two days.
Well, thank you very much to you as well. Dave, do you want to say anything
very
quickly?
It was fun, very interesting, and I noticed, again, extremes in the temperature based on where I was. The so-called haunted pew up there was very, very cold. When we came in from the break, however, as I entered the center into the aisle, I noticed it very warm, however.
Mm.
So it seemed, it felt as though there was some kind of radiated heat, and then of course it dissipated, but that's what I felt when we first walked in here,
did you smell the alcohol in the breath?
I did not, but what I feel here, again, the building is very well maintained, and I just feel that it's settled. I don't feel anything particularly out of normal or out of whack here.
No, it's not an unpleasant environment.
No,
not at all.
No, not at all. I don't find it to be threatening.
When you come here in the summer, this church in the daytime is absolutely wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful day.
Mm-hmm.
Well, look, I very much appreciate you coming over and joining us tonight.
My pleasure,
it's
sure.
It's been a really, really interesting investigation. And, of course, to all you good folks, thank you very much for tuning in. And, of course,
Should I have now walked off?
I'll do it again.
Okay.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much tonight for tuning in on this investigation at Sandton Church. I know it's a church we've been to before, but it is a church that has activity. I always say I'd rather come back to a place like this a few times and pick up activity than go to places where I'm picking up absolutely nothing at all. So hopefully tonight's been a rewarding session. So my thanks to everybody that's here, and of course my thanks to you for tuning in. And for me, good night.
Cut!
Right, I'm calling it now, but I'll pull the gear away, so that's going to take a few
minutes.
So where are we going to go from now?
I don't know.
Here you go, can you step out? I'll go with you.
Something British.
Something British. I know, it's McDonald's.
McDonald's.